Hello everyone, welcome to Engineering Concept. Now in this video I am discussing about IC engine and comparison of auto, diesel and dual cycle. An internal combustion engine is a heat engine in which the combustion of a fuel occurs with an oxidizer in a combustion chamber that is an integral part of the working fluid flow circuit. Now, engines are divided into two categories on the basis of number of stroke, 4-stroke engine and 2-stroke engine. You can see a 4-stroke engine in this picture. The name of the 4 strokes are intake, compression, power and exhaust. In intake stroke, piston moves from top dead center to bottom dead center and fresh charges come into the combustion chamber. Top dead center is the piston position near to the cylinder head and bottom dead center is the farthest position of piston from the cylinder head. In compression stroke, piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center and compresses the charges inside the combustion chamber. This stroke increases the pressure and temperature of the fuel. In power stroke, piston moves down from top dead center to bottom dead center due to expansion of gas in combustion chamber. And in exhaust stroke, piston moves again from bottom dead center to top dead center and the exhaust gases go out of the combustion chamber. So now see a 2-stroke engine in this picture. Name of the 2 strokes are upstroke and downstroke. You can see in this picture that during upstroke, when piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center, intake and ignition takes place simultaneously. Fuel mixture is drawn into the crank through the valve. Here, transfer port is covered by the piston. So the piston compresses the fuel which comes before in the combustion chamber. Now, see the second part of this picture. During downstroke, transfer port and exhaust port are uncovered and the fuel mixture is forced into the combustion chamber. This compresses the fuel mixture, pushes out the burned fuel gases from the combustion chamber. Different parameters associated with piston cylinder arrangement. Piston swept volume equals to Vs. This is the volume swept by piston inside the combustion chamber. TDC is top dead center, BDC is bottom dead center. D is nominal inner diameter of cylinder called piston diameter in general. L is length traveled by piston between TDC and BDC. Now swept volume equals to pi D square L upon 4. Simply the volume of a cylinder. Clearance volume is the volume when piston is at the top dead center. Total volume equals to swept volume plus clearance volume. Total volume is the volume when piston is at the bottom dead center. Now, compression ratio R equals to volume before compression upon volume after compression. Now it is simplified, V total upon VC. On simplification we get 1 plus swept volume upon clearance volume. Now auto cycle. It consists of 4 processes. Process 1 to 2, reversible adiabatic compression, also called as रिवर्सिबल आइसेंट्रोपिक कंप्रेसर, दैट इज एंट्रोपी इज कॉन्स्टेंट इन दिस प्रोसेस. प्रोसेस 2 to 3 इज कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम हीट एडिशन. प्रोसेस 3 to 4 इज रिवर्सिबल एडियाबेटिक एक्सपेंशन और रिवर्सिबल आइसेंट्रोपिक एक्सपेंशन. प्रोसेस 4 to 1 इज कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम हीट रिजेक्शन. हीट एडिशन एंड हीट रिजेक्शन डज नॉट टेक्स प्लेस एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. आई विल डिस्कस अबाउट इट इन फर्दर स्लाइड्स. ओके, नाउ एफिशिएंसी ऑफ ऑटो साइकिल इज 1 - 1/r गामा -1, वेयर आर इज कंप्रेशन रेशियो एंड गामा इक्वल्स टू CP/CV, वेयर CP इज कॉन्स्टेंट हीट कैपेसिटी एट स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर एंड स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. एज द कंप्रेशन रेशियो आर इंक्रीजेज, एफिशेंसी इंक्रीजेज. हियर यू कैन सी व्हेन आर इंक्रीजेज द टर्म 1/r गामा -1 डिक्रीजेज एंड फर्दर 1 - 1/r गामा -1 इंक्रीजेज. सो एफिशिएंसी इंक्रीजेज. लिमिट ऑफ कंप्रेशन रेशियो इज सब्जेक्टेड टू नॉकिंग फेनोमेना इन SI इंजन. वी कैन इंक्रीज द कंप्रेशन रेशियो अप टू अ सर्टेन लिमिट इन SI इंजन, लाइक R इक्वल्स टू इन द रेंज ऑफ 6 to 11. इफ वी फर्दर इंक्रीज द वैल्यू then it then knocking may occur in the cylinder. An isentropic expansion could do more work in Otto cycle if allowed to continue to lowest cycle pressure. Then Otto cycle becomes Atkinson cycle with same temperature limit. Here you can see in this picture heat rejection takes place at constant pressure. In case of Atkinson cycle, the process 4-2-1, and in case of Otto cycle, heat rejection takes place at constant volume during the process 4-1. Area shown in 1-4-4 is additional work obtained in Atkinson cycle. For same temperature limit, Atkinson cycle will have less heat rejection than Otto cycle, as the heat rejection in Atkinson is at constant pressure, not diesel cycle. There are 4 processes in diesel cycle also. It is same to that of Otto cycle. Only the process 2 to 3, that is constant pressure heat addition, is different in case of diesel cycle. We have seen that in case of Otto cycle, process 2 to 3 is constant volume heat addition. Remaining processes are same as that of Otto cycle. Now there are 3 types of ratio used in deriving the efficiency of diesel cycle. These are cutoff ratio, expansion ratio and compression ratio. Cutoff ratio equals to volume after combustion upon volume before combustion. Here V3/V2. V3 you can see in the diagram that V3 is the volume after combustion and V2 is volume before combustion. Expansion ratio is volume after expansion, here V4, and volume before expansion, that is V3. Compression ratio equals to V1/V2, that is volume before compression upon volume after compression. Also R equal to RC into RE. Now efficiency of diesel cycle equals to 1 - 1/r गामा माइनस वन इंटू आर सी गामा माइनस वन अपॉन आर सी माइनस वन, वेयर आर इज कंप्रेशन रेशियो, आर सी इज कट ऑफ रेशियो एंड गामा इक्वल्स टू सी पी अपॉन सी बी, वेयर सी पी इक्वल्स टू स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर एंड सी वी इक्वल्स टू स्पेसिफिक हीट कैपेसिटी एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम. एज द कंप्रेशन रेशियो इंक्रीजेज और कट ऑफ रेशियो डिक्रीजेज, थर्मल इफिशियंसी ऑफ डीजल इंजन इंक्रीजेज. इफ आइसेंट्रॉपिक एक्सपेंशन ऑफ डीजल इंजन इज अलाउड टू लोएस्ट साइकिल प्रेशर एंड देन फॉलोड बाई हीट रिजेक्शन एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर, इट बिकम्स जूल साइकिल विथ सेम टेम्परेचर लिमिट. हेयर यू कैन सी इन दिस पिक्चर दैट हीट रिजेक्शन इन केस ऑफ डीजल साइकिल टेक्स प्लेस एट कॉन्स्टेंट वॉल्यूम, प्रोसेस 4:1, वेयर एज इन केस ऑफ जूल साइकिल हीट रिजेक्शन टेक्स प्लेस ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस 4:1, दैट इज एट कॉन्स्टेंट प्रेशर. For same temperature limit, Joule cycle will have less heat rejection than diesel engine because heat rejection in Joule cycle is at constant pressure to all cycle and consists of 5 processes. First one is similar to Otto and diesel cycle, that is reversible adiabatic compression. Second process is constant volume heat addition, which resembles the Otto cycle. This process also takes place in Otto cycle, constant volume heat addition. Third one is process 3:4, that is constant pressure heat addition. It is same to that of diesel cycle. Fourth one is process 4:5, that is reversible adiabatic expansion. And the last one is constant volume heat rejection. Compression ratio equals to V1 upon V2, that is volume before compression upon volume after compression, and pressure ratio equals to P3 upon P2, that is pressure after heat addition upon pressure before heat addition. Thermal efficiency of dual cycle is given by this formula, 1 minus 1 upon R gamma minus 1 into RP into RC to the power gamma minus 1 upon RP minus 1 plus RP gamma into RC minus 1. If pressure ratio equals to 1, then dual cycle becomes diesel cycle. Pressure ratio 1 means P3 equal to P2. So when P3 equal to P2, the line 3:4 slides down to 2 and we get the same cycle as that of the diesel cycle. If cutoff ratio 1, then dual cycle becomes Otto cycle. Cutoff ratio 1 means V3 equals to V4. So the point 4 coincides with the point 3. Point 4 coincides with point 3. So what we get is same as that of the Otto cycle. Next. Heat addition or rejection at constant volume is not practically possible. But for the sake of our convenience, we consider heat addition or rejection to occur at constant volume in Otto and diesel cycle. In Otto, diesel or dual cycle, large amount of pressure difference is created just after the power stroke, because about 95% of exhaust gases escape out before the piston moves from bottom dead center to top dead center. So practically it is impossible to create constant pressure heat rejection. These are the actual diagrams of Otto cycle and Diesel cycle. Left one is for Otto cycle and the right one is for Diesel cycle. Here you can see that heat addition takes place at constant, is not practically at constant volume in case of Otto cycle, but it is almost at constant volume. That's why we choose to draw a constant volume line in theoretical cycle. And heat rejection takes place again almost at constant volume, but not exactly at constant volume. And in the right figure you can see the Diesel cycle diagram, in which heat addition takes place in process 2 to 3, where heat addition takes place in process 2 to 3, that is at constant pressure, and heat rejection takes place from 4 to 1, that is at constant volume, not almost constant volume, but it is about to constant volume. Compression of cycles. For same compression ratio and heat addition, efficiency of Otto cycle is greater than that of duo cycle, and efficiency of duo cycle is greater than that of Diesel cycle. For same compression ratio and heat rejection, efficiency of Otto cycle is greater than duo cycle, and efficiency of duo is greater than that of Diesel cycle. For same maximum temperature and heat rejection, Diesel efficiency is greater than that of dual, and dual is greater than that of Otto. For same maximum pressure and heat input, efficiency of Diesel is greater than that of dual, and efficiency of dual is greater than that of Otto cycle. For same maximum pressure and heat output, efficiency of Diesel engine is greater than that of dual, and efficiency of dual is greater than that of Otto cycle. So these few are important points which may be asked in many of interviews, so must remember these, try to understand how this happens. Thank you.